Hi guys, today we're making creamy shrimp spaghetti. Here's the picture. Here's the ingredients. Here's the instructions and the pictures. So for this recipe, you're going to need a pot and a pan. You're going to need a zester. You're going to need a couple of small bowls, if that's kind of your thing, like they have in here. They've kind of separated everything into a small bowl, so it's just easier that way. But in this recipe, we've got a whole thing of broccoli, which we're going to have to chop up here in a second. We've got some spaghetti. We've got shrimp. We have some garlic left over from the heads of garlic. We need, I think, three cloves of garlic. We have this lemon. We have a tiny thing of crushed red pepper flakes. We have some butter. And we have this thing called quark cheese. I've never had it. I have no idea what it tastes like, except it says on here that quark is tart and tangy. So, sure. All right, so first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to bring a pot of water, salted water, on high so that it starts to boil. I'm going to chop up the broccoli and mince the garlic. I'm going to zest about 2 teaspoons of the lemon and a quarter of them. Then I'm going to cook the broccoli 5 to 7 minutes with olive oil, salt, and pepper in the pan. So let me get that started. I'm cooking the broccoli now on medium high for 5 to 7 minutes with salt and pepper and oil.
Okay, so I'm going to take the spaghetti and I'm going to put it in the hot water for 8 to 10 minutes. Okay, so once the broccoli is all done, we're going to add in the garlic and as much of the red pepper flakes as you want. And we're going to cook that down for just about a minute until it's nice and fragrant. Okay, I'm going to add in 1/2 cup of water. And I'm going to cook this 3 to 4 more minutes, adding some more salt and pepper once some of the liquid is cooked down. So basically you're waiting for the water to either cook off or the broccoli to soften more. Also with the spaghetti, I'm going to reserve 1 cup of the liquid once it's done. Okay, I'm now going to add the shrimp. It was on a paper towel because I was basically had to pat them dry and season them with salt and pepper. And now we're going to cook them 2 to 3 minutes. Alright, so once this is done and it's about to be done, I'm just going to turn off the heat and take it off the burner while I drain the spaghetti. Okay. Basically, we're going to add everything into the pan. So
I am putting in the spaghetti. I am going to put in half the liquid of the pasta water, adding in lemon zest, adding in butter, adding in the juice of half of the lemon. So basically, I am going to cook this all down. I'm going to add in salt and pepper. I'm going to mix everything together. And get all this together for like another minute or two. Okay, so the very last thing that I am going to do is to turn off the heat and then add the quark cheese and then stir everything out together again. And that's it. Get ready to plate. So I'll be back to let you know what it looks like when it's all done. Okay, here it is. Looks pretty good. I'll be back to let you know what I think. Hi, I'm here to discuss the recipe. I really enjoyed this one. It was very similar to the lemon bucatini that we had last week. There was some differences. There wasn't as much lemon. I enjoyed the quark cheese. That was pretty good. I enjoyed the broccoli in it. I enjoyed the whole thing. There wasn't any part of that that I didn't enjoy. And you know how I feel about pasta without sauce. So that being said, I think I've changed my mind about pasta without sauce. I think you can not have sauce as long as it's flavored well. I would definitely make this again. Maybe not with spaghetti. Spaghetti is just not my favorite noodle. I'm just not a fan of long noodles. I prefer short noodles. Unless it's like ramen or something. I like ramen. But other than that, like, even with ramen, I kind of break it up. I'm such a bad person. But, so yeah, I enjoyed this one. Alright, so next week we have kind of decided to kind of go back and forth between Blue Apron and HelloFresh because, like, sometimes we just really don't like any of the choices on Blue Apron. I'll be honest about that. That's something we've noticed. This is our, like, third or fourth box, maybe? I think our third. And like, for next week, there was just, like, nothing. Like, the fact that, well, we would've, except they have that thing where if you choose one recipe, sometimes that means you can't, like, there's six choices, but sometimes you can't get all the choices you want. So if you know, say you want one thing, like a couple of other things means you can't get that. And I've heard it's because they get it from some other place. I don't know. But with HelloFresh, you can just pick the three that you want. There's no like stipulation about it. So that's kind of put a damper on Blue Apron for us. So in that case, we have kind of decided to go back and forth and pause whichever one doesn't have a recipe that we truly care for. So next week might be HelloFresh again. I totally forget which one's which coming up, but so yeah, thanks guys for watching, and I'll talk to you guys in my next video. All right, bye.